Welcome to Subramani. I hope more of you are subscribing to the channel and making the channel more popular. Thanks. But so I'm taking one more query from an investor called Alok Jhunjhunwala, and he is investing about 20. Okay, the funds in which he is investing 20,000 in Axis Blue Chip, 20K Mirai Asset Large Cap Fund, 15K Axis Mid Cap Fund, 15K in Kotak Emerging Fund, and 10K in SBI Focused Equity Funds. So all this put together is about 85,000. He has an 8-year time frame and his target is 3.5 crores. So I'm willing to invest extra 40,000 per month. Which new fund would be a better bet? So this is the question he has asked, and the answer to this is I found this very difficult to answer. Okay, nothing wrong. He's got 1-2 large cap funds. He's got 1 mid cap fund. He's got 1 emerging equity, again a mid cap fund, and a focused fund which is 10K, right? So the question is, unfortunately, too many advisors today are telling people, if you have a 10-year time frame, you should be putting more money in small cap and mid cap and less money in large cap, because these two will give you better alpha and give you better returns. In fact, there are IFAs who are telling clients that you would be better off buying Reliance and HDFC on your own and investing only in mid cap and small cap, because large caps are anyway buying only Infosys, Reliance and HDFC, which are overweight on the index. Please don't fall for this advice. It is right that these are the funds in which Alok Jhunjhunwala is investing, but Alok, please remember that when you have just an 8-year time frame, you've got to be very scared of putting so much money into equity. I would be better off, or rather you would be better off, in putting some money into debt, simply because the market is at 42,000, which is not very far away from its all-time high. When an index reaches all-time high, it does not mean that the index is going to fall, but it means the risk level in the market is going up and perhaps gone up. So which means, from PEs which are prevailing now, will you get great returns? I doubt whether you will get great returns from now. But yes, lage raho, you're still young, you're only 34 years of age. So you got a long way to go, and I don't know why you want a 3.5 crore corpus in 8 years. Maybe there is a specific reason, but if it is 8 years, then I would first of all shift to more of large cap, less of you don't have any small cap, so that's still okay, and less of mid cap. And every year I would want you to pull out at least 5% or 8%, maybe even 10% for next 2-3 years. And start putting into debt funds, because you do not know what the market is going to do. Now, when you start doing that, what will happen is your amount to debt will keep increasing. And if your goal is really 8 years, after 3 years, you suddenly realize that now you have only 5 years to go. When you have 5 years to go, no financial planner worth his salt would ever advise equity. Equity advice, at least as far as I am concerned as a blogger, I would advise only for people with at least 10 years. So right now at 8 years itself, you are slightly on slippery ground, but you seem to have been an investor for a long time and you are willing to put another 40,000 rupees. That 40,000 I would think you should put into a long-term debt fund. I think even maybe a corporate risk is still okay. Credit risk fund is also okay. But start doing an SIP there. I would remove some money from one of these funds and put it into a global advantage fund, which invests in many funds which have international exposure. So you will have exposure, little exposure to US, little exposure to Japan, little exposure to China, Korea, Taiwan, right? So all over the world, wherever things are happening, because fast growing companies are not available in India. Then there are some industries like defense and adult entertainment, which is not available in India. So maybe some of these funds will invest in those companies. And since you're already putting about almost a lakh of rupees, in fact 1,20,000, if you put that additional 40, taking a little bit of international exposure also makes sense. But please remember, with only 8 years to go, Starting to withdraw is also important. 8 years to go, I'm assuming, since you're asking this question in 2020, it means you require these funds in 2028. So somewhere around 2024 itself, I would withdraw bigger amounts and start providing for that date in 2028. However, 2028 is just a tentative number, and you want to buy a house, which could happen in 2026 or it could happen in 2032. Then I won't be too worried. But if 2028 is a hard stop, it's your daughter's class 12 and you want to pay for her medical seat or something like that, which means it has to be 2028, then I would start withdrawing money at least by 2023, because you never know what the markets will do. Also understand, market is not at a all-time low or anything. The PEs are high. Even for large cap, the PEs are high. So I would be a little guarded. I would not be so aggressive to put 1,20,000 per month into equity funds, hoping to create a corpus in the next 8 years. 8 years, not more than 60-70% should be in equity, and there should be a clear gradual withdrawal plan. Since you are in large cap, mid cap and small cap, in the same proportion in which you're putting, you will also withdraw. So if you're putting 30,000 per month, maybe you will start withdrawing, or maybe you will right now stop putting more money into equity. You already have money in equity, so stop putting, maybe put only 50%. Please also understand the limitations of my communication. I am communicating singly to you. I don't know whether you like what I'm saying, whether you dislike, whether you're going to listen to me. I have no clue. Whereas if I were your advisor, I would be sitting with you, talking about this, making the changes, seeing what is your attitude, talking to you, right? Here I'm only talking and I'm not listening at all. So it's very difficult for a media person to advise people. So it's normal for people to say, "Arey, aap to media mein aate ho, aap batao." But that's not right. I can talk broadly about saying, "Oh, Invesco is a good fund house. They're doing these things which are different." Or DSP is a different fund house. They're doing these things which are different. But it is too broad. Specifically, what you need, when you need, it's not something which I will be able to do as well as your advisor can. And today I get a lot of mails saying advisors only sell. That's true. There are many advisors who only sell, but there are some brilliant advisors who can add a lot of value. It is completely up to you to search for those advisors, seek their help, and then invest. If you don't want to do any of those things, be in index funds and start withdrawing from an index funds at least 4 years before you really require the money. Right, so 20% in the first year, or 15% in the first year, 25% in the second year, 30% in the third year, or maybe even 70% in the third year, and be done with it. Last 15-16 months, you don't put money in equity, that's still fine. So first of all, stop putting so much money into equity, because your goal is just 8 years away. The next 40,000 which you want to put definitely goes into some kind of a long-term debt fund, because have a look at the maturity of that paper. If the paper maturity is 5 or 6 years, it's worth taking some kind of an interest rate risk that you are, interest movement risk, because interest could move against you within the next year or two. So be alert to it. Again, if you don't understand, be careful. Your PPF, if you have a PPF, you remember you can withdraw from that. So pump money into your PPF also. 40K a month you have, so which means you have 5 lakhs to invest. At least put 1.5 lakhs in your PPF account, and in your wife's PPF account. If you have a minor kid, you cannot put, but if your kid is a major, you can put money into the major kid's account. So start putting money into debt schemes. Start withdrawing from equity at least from 2022-23, first slowly, then aggressively. And if the market goes up and your goal money is ready, just completely withdraw in 2025 or 26 and put the money into ultra short bond fund, so that you can use the money by 2028. Please understand, such specific hand holding can hardly be done by people like me, sitting so far away, not knowing where you are. You need a financial advisor who will do it, or you will do the self-learning process. Watching my videos will equip you reasonably well to ask the right questions to the IFA. Maybe I would think you would make a decent, well-informed person, but does not make you a doctor. Don't try things which professionals do. It has a lot of dangers. Please read offer documents carefully, like they say. Thank you.